in the process of laminating the OCA front glass with OLED. Front glass and the OLED are pressurized by the machine. If the power is unevenly distributed, or the temperature is too high or too low, the air has failed to escape, the bubbles will form. Most of the bubbles can be eliminated after defoaming. As for stubborn bubbles, it requires a second separation and lamination. By combining principles and practical application experience, REWA Lab summarizes a few key points for reducing air bubbles and avoid stubborn bubbles. Correct operation techniques, suitable tools and supplies, and accurate laminating machine parameter settings. Let's check out a demonstration of the operating points of flat screen. The first step is front glass separation. Front glass separations are generally categorized into bracket preserving and non-bracket preserving separations. The prerequisite for preserving the bracket is a good appearance without breaks, while retaining the original for bracket separation can have the benefit of a better fit match. It requires too many skills for beginners. By comparison, we can see that use non-bracket preserving separation method would make it easier to locate the gap between the front glass and OLED. Therefore, it is recommended that beginners use the non-bracket preserving separation. Use cutting wire to separate the OLED. Get an entry point from the bottom corner of the screen. Start separating the OLED along the bottom layer of the glass with cutting wire. After the front glass is removed, clean the OCA adhesive. Thoroughly removing OCA adhesive is the basis for successful lamination. Commonly used tools for removing glue are electric OCA glue remover, OCA glue remover spray and OCA glue remover sheets, which are suitable for different situations. Electric OCA glue remover has wider adaptability, moderately difficult to operate, relatively time sensitive. As for OCA glue remover spray, it is only suitable for iPhone 10 and later models. It will dissolve the OCA adhesive easily and not damage the phone. This method is less difficult to operate and more efficient. The OCA glue remover sheets are used for cleaning the glass residual after OLED separation. Relatively difficult to operate. After cleaning the OCA glue, the OLED function is normal. Let's go to the next step. The OLED is in a bent state. Gently straighten it before putting it into the alignment mold. High precision molds are well suited to front cover and OLED, improved positioning accuracy. Check the alignment status. Confirm the alignment is flat, does not warp and slide. We went with a Mitsubishi OCA front glass. Use the sticker while tearing the film, to prevent OCA deformation. Some wrong ways, like using tweezers to tear the film, would easily cause damage to the OCA, cause air bubbles after lamination. Clean the OLED again. Place the OCA front glass horizontally into the alignment molds. The mold was set with spring tabs to help keep the cover in horizontal position with the OLED. Tap the center of the front glass to make OCA stick attached to the OLED partly. The middle of the front cover and the center of OLED must be bonded first, so that the OLED will not easily remove when inverted. Invert the mold flatly and take out the OLED. Using two 6mm rubber mats, place the screen into the FM30. Setting machine parameters. Lamination complete. We put the screen back to the phone and test the display and touch function. Display and touch functions are perfect. Apply OEM glue evenly around the bracket. Align the laminated OLED. Take out the OLED and press it. Here are the main points of refurbishing a flat screen. Next, we take the Samsung S10 for curved screen front glass lamination. Three key points for curved screen lamination: dedicated fitting alignment mold, set the machine pressure, and UV curing after lamination. Let's start with the test. Display and touch function are normal. We use YMJ's dedicated locating mold with laminating rubber mat. Put the rubber mat on the rubber locating mold. Fixed it into the base mold. Place the OLED into locating mold. Place it onto the rubber locating mold. Attach the OLED to the rubber tightly. Note, the rubber mat need to fit well enough with the OLED. Insufficient lamination results in air bubble appearing again. Clean the OLED. Place the front glass into the glass locating mold. Use a strip to tear the OCA protective film. Put the glass locating mold onto the base mold. Put into REFOX FM50 for lamination. Machine parameter setting. It is recommended to get the exact parameters from the machine supplier. Parametric problems may result in insufficient pressure, which is likely to affect lamination and defoaming effect. After lamination, put it into the defoaming bin for defoaming. Finally, put the defoam screen into the UV curing box. Cure the OCA adhesive to prevent the air bubble. The screen is functional and there are no bubbles. Perfect front glass lamination requires consistent practice. The REWA team has selected a set of high-performance equipment suitable for flat and curved screens, as well as refurbishment training courses to enhance your refurbishment business. Please contact our account manager if you're interested. Leave your comment below if you have any suggestions or questions. Thanks for watching.